Well, 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 The Undertaker has gone on the Joe Rogan Experience and let rip on the current day environment as far as backstage in WWE, how wrestlers of today are soft. Once again, talking about the evolution of the business, how wrestlers aren't taking on board the feedback and the advice and the constructive criticism of legends, and more so focusing on the aesthetics, you know, them playing video games, how they look, the in-ring component as opposed to the larger-than-life sports entertainer side of things that really sold and makes mainstream money. Taker went in on all this kind of stuff, as well as many things on this podcast. He talked about, you know, the environment back in the day in the locker room, him potentially, well, coming back. Well, he's not. He said he's not coming back, but he addressed that kind of stuff. He addressed just WWE in general and different tidbits about that. Plenty of stuff was talked about in the Joe Rogan Experience, but really today, what I'm going to be doing is talking about The Undertaker calling the current day roster soft, the current day locker room soft, with the exception of a couple of guys. The locker room, by and large, is soft. Now, one thing I want to address before I get into this, I've got to say this, because when I did this, a very similar type of video about Jim Ross, and the comments Jim Ross made on his podcast about 5 weeks ago, I saw a number of these comments, and inevitably these comments are going to come on this video. I just want to address this. The Undertaker knows more about the inner sanctum of WWE. He knows more about what makes a pro wrestler, a sports entertainer, great and make money. He knows more about that than literally anyone on the planet. Okay, outside of maybe Vince McMahon and maybe, like, yeah, I don't know, your Bruce Pritchards. Outside of that, Undertaker knows more about the inner sanctum and all that kind of stuff than anyone. Undertaker, Mark Callaway, was around the inner sanctum from the late 80s. Back, as he says, with, you know, the guns and knives running rampant, he was back in the backstage area in the inner sanctum back then, into the 90s, the golden era, the new generation era, the attitude era, the ruthless aggression era, the Super Cena version of the PG era, then the SJW snowflake version of the PG era. Undertaker's been around for the whole thing. So this guy, Mark Callaway, knows the inner sanctum better than absolutely anyone. So without further ado, with that being said, now I'm going to read you some quotes from The Undertaker on the Joe Rogan Experience podcast. So, during the interview, Taker was asked if he still follows the WWE product and whether he enjoys the current programming. Replying to it, the Phenom said, "It's tough for him to enjoy because the product has changed." He says, quote, "I try. It's tough right now for me to enjoy the product because the product has changed so much and it's kind of soft. I'll probably piss a lot of people off, but they need to hear it. It is what it is. To the young guys who think, oh, he's a bitter old guy, I'm not bitter. I did my time. I'm good. I walked away when I wanted to walk away." So that's the quote there. Then, The Undertaker admitted that while there are some guys who have an edge to them, the product is ultimately a little too soft for his taste. Taker says, quote, "I just think the product is a little soft. There's obviously guys here and there..." So, unquote for a second. When Taker says there are obviously guys here and there that have an edge to them, he means Drew McIntyre, Roman Reigns, Karrion Kross, these type of guys. So I just want to give some examples there. Moving on with the Taker quote, they have an edge to them, but there's plenty, or well, there's too much pretty and not enough substance, I think, right now. So that's the Taker quote there. Then he went on to address the real culture in the locker room, in the inner sanctum. He really did go into good detail with this. So Taker, he specifically also mentioned guys playing video games backstage in WWE. Taker said, quote, "You go into a dressing room nowadays and it's a lot different. I remember walking into my first real dressing room and all I saw was some crusty effing men. Half of them had guns and knives in their bags. Stuff got handled back then. Now you walk in, there's guys playing video games and making sure they look pretty. It's evolution, I guess. I don't know what it is, but I just like those eras, man. I liked it when men were men." So that's what Undertaker had to say regarding video games in WWE in the locker room, just the locker room culture in general, the current product being soft, not as enjoyable. The first thing I want to say is, how can you disagree with Undertaker here? I know people are going to disagree with this video, it comes to the nature of the beast, but when I think of, you know, what Taker said here, you know, the general sentiments he's made, how can you not agree? Now, the main thing I want to address before anything else, Undertaker, when he says that when he went into his first real dressing room and he saw guns, knives, you know, steroids running rampant, when it was that culture, Undertaker is not saying that because nowadays there's video games instead of guns, steroids, drugs, etc. He's not saying that because of the contrast that it's inherently soft nowadays. It's more so because of just the general masculinity culture of back in the day and how that's faded away. Okay, you don't need guns, knives, you know, steroids and all that to be masculine and really be alphas and all that kind of stuff in the backstage setting and really strive to be a great sports entertainer who makes money on a mainstream stage. Okay, you don't need the guns, the knives and that type of stuff to be that ambitious and want to be the best possible sports entertainer. But what Undertaker is really talking about here with the softness and all this kind of stuff, well, the softness comes from not being as ambitious enough to hit the weights for, you know, several more hours than you need to. Okay, these people, the wrestlers of today, are far more concerned, by and large, okay, obviously some exemptions here and there, but by and large, the wrestlers coming in nowadays are wrestlers who are marks for the business itself, marks for the matches, and these are wrestlers who, they grew up wanting to be in the ring, and now they're in the ring and they're experimenting with moves, not really so much the character and what makes them great. Okay, Bayley, when she was on the Stone Cold Broken Skull Sessions with Steve Austin, she addressed this herself. Bayley said, I'm paraphrasing for a second here, Bayley talked about how she'd grown up being such a massive wrestling fan, idolizing the business, idolizing the big stars of the Attitude Era, the Ruthless Aggression Era, that when Bayley got into the business and she had to do promos and she had to really build up a character for herself, she absolutely struggled. She'd spend months and months and months in the performance center, in promo classes, working with Dusty Rhodes, working with producers to try and think of a character, because she quite frankly had nothing. Okay, Bayley had absolutely no character to go on. She was just someone who loved the business and loved wrestling matches. That's what Bayley was in like 2012, 13, 14. She said this herself in the Broken Skull Sessions with Steve Austin, okay? Bayley is a prime example. I mean, nowadays Bayley's gotten better with the, you know, the mic skills and the character, but that's almost an exemption compared to most people, because most people nowadays, God forbid, Ricochet, Ali, I mean, take your pick, you can name most of the roster. I mean, dead set, a lot of NXT has this same issue. This whole issue of, okay, you're spending most of your time focusing on learning and practicing moves that are quite frankly dangerous and unnecessary, okay? Moves which have no psychology, for example, Sami Zayn's through the ropes DDT that has no psychology whatsoever. Instead of jumping through the ropes, grabbing the guy, spinning around in a 720 degree motion, and then dumping him on the outside to the floor, wouldn't it be better to just run and punch the guy? Okay, psychologically speaking, these acrobatic, aesthetically pleasing moves, which wrestlers nowadays take pride upon and really build their games upon, these moves aesthetically have been proven to not draw in the mainstream, okay? These types of wrestlers and these types of offensive arsenals and these types of pro wrestlers, these aren't the people to get over, okay? The Vince McMahon type of pro wrestler is a guy who won't get injured from doing these moves, a guy who looks legitimate, looks credible, looks larger than life, has a character, catchphrases, a, you know, distinctive entrance, gets over because of that, and accordingly has a safe in-ring style that won't get them hurt, okay? You've seen that trend, you've seen the guys who really get over, the guys who really succeeded in the business follow that same trajectory, okay? Guys who wrestle this style, where it's about the softness, it's about what move can I do that looks most aesthetically pleasing. For example, on NXT this past week, who was it again? It was in the tag team match, it was Tony Storm and I forget her partner, that tag team match. The finish of that match, we saw a wonderful Code Hero suicide dive off the top rope onto Tony Storm. I'm thinking to myself, is this necessary at all? Can you not just jump on, just do a straightforward, just dive off the top rope, just onto Tony Storm? You have to do a 720 degree plancha hurricane rana 850 flippy do like move just to try and get an ooh and an ah from the crowd. Okay, that's not what gets over with the mainstream. It's been proven when you look in the history of pro wrestling, who are the people who've drawn the most money? How have they gotten over? What's been their style? Distinctive character, aesthetically mainstream, that guy could beat you up type look. Okay, these guys don't look like video gamers, okay? No one's looking at Steve Austin and thinking, oh, that dude plays 8 hours a day of Mortal Kombat, okay? That's not the case. You don't look at Hulk Hogan and think, oh, he spent 9 hours a day on Super Smash Bros. Okay, like, this is the thing Undertaker's talking about. Guys back in the day, to, you know, really sound like an old-timer here, even though I'm not even half the age of most of the wrestlers nowadays, guys back in the day, what the thing would be is you'd spend 3, 4, 5, 6 hours in the weights room. You'd spend excessive time working on your character, going to people. What can I do to build my character? Can I do an extra promo class? How can I be a better all-round professional wrestler? Not just, how can I execute this move better? Oh, because nowadays, all the thing is, oh, Shawn Michaels, how can I execute a better Hurricane Rana Plancha DDT? Triple H, can you please give me advice on how I can execute a better 720 splash? Like, this is the type of stuff you have nowadays, okay? And the people who are trying to work on their characters, it's just not clicking, okay? We haven't really seen enough of these larger-than-life characters in the past 15 years, okay? We saw Cena, we saw Batista, CM Punk captured the imagination of fans because of his promos, and who else has done it? I mean, maybe AJ Styles to an extent, but really the only other ones I can think of, Reigns and McIntyre. Those are the two other guys who have really clicked as far as that mainstream, like have that mainstream look, the mainstream appeal. I mean, that's really about it. Because as Taker talks about here, you know, the culture of the locker room, video game culture. Now, I'm not someone who thinks, oh, you play video games, you're not a real man. That's a stupid mentality. If you think that playing video games doesn't make you a real man, that's dumb. You can play 3 hours of video games a day, and then you can hit the weights for 2 hours, you can do a bunch of other blokey type stuff, you can do tradie work and work on construction sites and all this kind of, you know, real man type stuff that you want. You can still play video games. Like, playing video games doesn't inherently make you soft. I think that whole mentality is stupid. But to say that the guys nowadays are more worried about gaming as opposed to looking like a wrestler, Adam Cole... Sorry, what? To think that Adam Cole, instead of spending an extra 1, 2, 3 hours a day in the weights room, you know, if he did that for many years, you think of how jacked Adam Cole could be now. It wouldn't just be this thing of he's the go-to video games greater than, looking like a buff wrestler type thing. It's just, I think you should be able to take my point in this video. Undertaker makes a bunch of valid points as far as why the current day product and the current day wrestlers are not either ambitious enough, either, you know, the softness, okay? Not all guys are soft. I think the word soft is a bit... It depends person to person. Undertaker literally said that, and that not every guy is, like, inherently soft. There are guys who, you know, are what pro wrestlers back in the day used to be, probably McIntyre, Reigns, etc. But by and large, it's guys who sit backstage and want to make sure they look pretty. Guys like Tyler Breeze, guys like Dolph Ziggler, guys like, you can just name them on and on. You can go up and down the roster, and you can literally go, that guy, that guy, that guy, that guy, fits Taker's description right here. So, that's going to be the video. Hopefully, you guys have enjoyed it. If you have, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and drill. See ya.